You're listening to Breaking Balls with Fishy Wogarty in association with Bridie Bonham's Bakery. In one hole and out the other.
You're very welcome back to Breaking Bars with me, Fishy Wogarty, 0647166 or 0833-300-3300. Tanya's taking your calls, or alternatively, you can email the show on busbybabe@earcom.net. That's busbybabe@earcom.net. Now, we have a very special guest on the show tonight. He mightn't be here on the best of circumstances, as he was recently sacked from his managerial post at Fulham, but I'm delighted to say we're joined by former Ajax, Tottenham, and now former Fulham manager, Martin Jol. Martin, you're very welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Vichy. It's great to be here in the kingdom of Kerry, as I believe you call it. I came here a number of years ago to the town of Killarney. Yeah, I came to Killarney with a number of friends from the Netherlands. We came over for a stag party. It was a really crazy night. Ended up in the cathedral in the middle of the town at 4 a.m. drinking altar wine.
Okay, Martin, we're going to have to cut across you there. No, this is a family show, so we'll stick to talking about the soccer. But tell me this now, Martin. How did you get here anyway? How did you fly over? Did you get the ferry?
Well, I flew over today. I flew from Luton Airport to Kerry Airport, only 1 hour, 20 minutes, very handy. When I was in the Final Four, then I hitchhiked a lift from an old woman who was going to Tralee to do her shopping in Lidl. In Lidl, a very nice lady dropped me all the way, but Jesus, she did not stop fucking talking. She reminded me of my mother.
Speaking of family now, Martin, have you got a family of your own? Have you any brothers and sisters?
Yes, I do. I have two brothers, one both working in football, one is a referee, and the other is a football scout.
And what are their names?
Dick and Cock.
Sorry?
Dick and Cock.
Dick and Cock. 0647166 or 0833-300-3300. Tanya's taking your call, or alternatively, you can email the show at busbybabe@earcom.net. That's busbybabe@earcom.net. Martin, tell me, how have you been dealing the last few days now with being sacked? I say it's fairly lonely, is it?
Well,
I'd say you know how to do it yourself.
Well,
I'd say you're walking around the house aimlessly.
Well, if you let me talk, I'll tell you what I'm doing okay. I'm doing okay, Vichy. I have time to relax in the comfort of my own home.
Doing what now, exactly?
Well, mainly sitting on my couch watching reruns of EastEnders and Holby City whilst feasting on a box of Quality Street, you know?
Ah, yes, Quality Street, but I'd be more of a Roses man myself now, Martin. But tell me this, Martin. How is it possible for a team like Fulham, based in London, who finished 12th last season in the Premier League, to have such a shit start to the season? Can you tell me that, Martin?
Well, Fishy, a number of factors are at play, as you know. Lack of funding from the board is one, and then the increasing prices of top quality players and like wankers like Manchester United and Man City buying everybody, and then of course the simple fact that our goalkeeper Martin Stecklenburg is fucking shit.
Yeah, he's fairly bad, all right. No, he actually reminds me now, Martin. He reminds me of the Cork goalie in the All Ireland final in 2007, wouldn't you?
Yes, Alan Quirk. He was very bad goalkeeper. I remember that day actually because he looked like a cross between Taibbi, the old Manchester United goalkeeper, a cross between Taibbi and Bambi on ice. It was very funny.
Yeah, that was very funny day altogether. No, but I'm just going to read out a number of text messages there now that are coming in from the public. We have one here. Martin, you were great at Spurs. Hope you replace AVB as he is an absolute disaster. That is from Billy McGrann Kilcoman. And another text message coming in here says, Martin, you look like an uncle of Raymond van Barneveld. Now, that's a very interesting one.
Yes, that is an interesting one. I get that quite a lot, actually. But people don't know that me and Barney, we know each other from the Netherlands. We used to be postmen together. But now I'd like to say I'm more of a Van Gerwen fan.
Yeah, whatever. But Martin, tell me this. Have you any plans for the future?
Well, there's a number of managerial positions up for grabs, as you know. So we have Owen Coyle left Wigan recently. Things aren't looking good for Sam Allardyce at West Ham. But next year, I really hope, to take over the Mayo senior football team. You know, because those poor fuckers need all the luck they can.
But Martin, if you were to get the Mayo job, what would be the first thing you'd do?
Well, Fishy, firstly, I'd perform an exorcism on the Mayo dressing room to get rid of any poltergeists and spirits. I'd wash all the jerseys in holy water. And then we could probably have a station mass at my house and have tea and sandwiches, maybe get to know each other a little better.
That sounds like an absolutely fantastic plan, Martin, and the best of luck to you, and I hope you get it. And then, Martin, maybe you'll be the man to give them a bit of Dutch courage.
Yes, Dutch courage. I can give them that.
Fair play to you, Martin. Now stay tuned after the break where you could be in with a chance of winning a fantastic prize of a box of Zip Fire lighters and a packet of Bourbon creams. Stay tuned after the break.
You're listening to Breaking Balls with Fishy Wogarty in association with Bridie Bonham's Bakery. In one hole and out the other.